Hey, I'm Matthew Morris, and I want to take a few minutes to talk to you about this camera right here, the Fujifilm X-H1. Now, next to it, I have a Fujifilm X-T3, about mid-2019. I went out and I bought an X-H1, and it is now pretty much dominating what camera I use. Let's take a look at these two cameras here, right? X-T3, really fast autofocus. Or X-H1, pretty much an X-T2 with a little bit extra speed. Here's the big difference. And yes, there's more specs that you can compare. No in-body image stabilization, in-body image stabilization, or IBIS. And that is why I'm using the X-H1 when I go out and shoot, because shots like this one at 1/20th of a second, as I'm standing on an escalator, paralleling the escalator that she is on, I don't think I would have gotten that shot as crisp with the X-T3. Here's another shot. Now look to the right of him. The edge on him is incredibly crisp. If you look even farther to the right, you'll see there's brickwork. When you zoom in, you can see the outline of the bricks. Now this is shot, and why I'm so excited about this and why I've been shooting with this primarily when I go out and shoot photos, not video, but photos. This was shot at 1/35th of a second, handheld, no tripod. The IBIS here allows you to take that shutter speed, and here, this is dark, this is in Five Point Station, it's an underground subway station. You can see through the train, details across those windows. That is the other side of the platform going the other direction. And those brickwork behind it is a good another 30 to 40 feet beyond this individual here. That is how crisp this image got. This image, in-body image stabilization, is no joke. It allows you to take that triangle, that exposure triangle, take a portion of it, which is the shutter speed, and say, hey, you know what, I need more light, or I want motion in my image. Now here's another shot why I think this in-body image stabilization really helps. So I'm on the train at the, what now would be the last car, because we're pulling away from the station, not the first car, but the last car. The train is beginning to move, and it's starting to rock. This is at 1/70th of a second. And as you look through this window into the compartment, everything's in focus. You can zoom in and you can see through the glass and the scratches and the spots, but you can read the sign that says to the street, to the airport terminal. Now this image here, this is a 60-second exposure. This was shot on the X-H1. On a little Joby tripod. In fact, it was this little Joby tripod. It's just incredibly, incredibly sharp. There's wind going on. There's people walking back and forth. I mean, look at the shot here from the front. Again, this is a 60-second shot. I mean, look at the details in the curve right in front of it, right? You know, the lines there are perfectly straight. Nothing is moving. You can even read what it says on the little plaque right there. And I really believe, and again, that's with that same Joby tripod, that is because of the in-body image stabilization in this X-H1. This 10-second exposure of downtown Los Angeles on the 35mm 1.4. So I'm on, as you can see here in the video, this ledge here. I'm on this little ledge. Maybe it's about this thick. And or this wide, deep. This little Joby tripod, this camera, 10-second exposure, and look at the image. It is really crisp for this. I didn't have a weighted tripod. Again, I know I'm saying it over and over again. Well, this in-body image stabilization in this camera, I believe, allows me to get images like this. I bought this camera because I thought that the IBIS could be a tool help me make my photos better. And indeed, I do think it's helping me get shots that I wouldn't have been able to get without it in situations where setting up a tripod was just not part of the equation, like shooting street in a subway system. Just not something you're gonna do. For me, I'm loving shooting with my X-H1, even though it has slightly older tech than my X-T3. The IBIS really though, puts it over the top for me. Let me know what you think. Put that in the comments below. Do you have a camera with IBIS? Do you have an X-H1? Do you want to get a camera with IBIS? Because I didn't think I did for the longest time until I said, you know what, let's try it. And boom, the results are in the actual photos itself. They look great. So otherwise, go out and make life an adventure.